Hello, ladies and gentlemen, it's your boy, Jax221, also known as Jax. And here we are, back at it again with another episode of Ty the Tasmanian Tiger. Parkour mode. I had no energy behind that, Jesus. Anyway, in our last episode, we got 100% in Bly Bly Station, which rewarded us with the first of five talismans and our spankin' new boomerang, the Flame Ring. So now we have two magical boomerangs that we could choose from. But I feel like we could use a bit more. So if you remember in our last episode, one of the many collectibles that we had to grab were these golden cogs. Well, when you get 10 golden cogs, when you get 15 golden cogs, you want to come down to the shack in the open main world area. And if we turn to the right, we got this machine.
I call it the Cogulacious Boomerangerous X.
All right, cool. We get the point, Julius. Yes, the golden cogs are necessary for unlocking new boomerangs. And the first one you can get are the Zoomerangs. These are basically boomerangs with a really long throw distance. That's it. And you can zoom in and snipe things from afar. Very nice. And our second boomerang is the Multi-Rang. Just gotta slap the throw button and throw a lot of boomerangs at once. So, yes, that's what the golden cogs are for, getting optional boomerangs. I like them, they're fun. They're not necessary for completing the game, but they do add a nice bit of variety. So, get those golden cogs, because you get some really cool boomerangs. And another thing that you might have noticed is Ty is looking a little bit different. That's because in the PC version and also the Switch version, there's a Switch version, by the way. This game's on the Switch, so, you know, buy it, support it, maybe get all the other games on Switch, just saying. And yeah, that's about it. So let's get on with the episode and go take on Crikey's Cavern, the second area of the game. Just gotta go around here and around this bend and ice. Don't worry, we got fire, which melts ice. Yes.
He's smarter than I thought.
Who's there? Was that you, God? I told you, I don't got any more money. You took it all.
Alrighty. On to area number two. Once again, same thing as before, so we'll just hop into the first level. Take it away, intro card. Alright, welcome to our newest level, River on the Tie. Yeah, so we got ourselves another, I can only describe as a, kind of like a swamp level. One of the things I noticed about, Tie is that they, like to reuse levels. Which, you know, isn't really a bad thing, like... Now, this was a cheap game. Cheap is like, they probably didn't have the same budget as like Mario or something, but you know, it's a little reskin never hurts. It saves time and money. They just reuse assets, give it different lighting, a few different enemies, but you know, it's doable. I like it. It's memorable. Anyway, now all of our red collectibles are blue. That's the biggest difference now. But yeah. It's a very chill level. You got ourselves a lovely moon just covered in craters. Just got it. How about that? How about that, Dorothy? Nice. Why are these boxes here? Where are they for? What secrets do these boxes hold? Now go ahead and talk to you, Janice.
It's not that I'm scared of the dark or anything, but...
Babaka?
Wait, was the frog scared by a frog? That makes no sense. What are the laws of this animal world? Alright, so we got an escort mission, ladies and gentlemen. Don't worry, it's not that bad. All I gotta do is just light our way and Dennis will take care of himself. Alright, cool. Alright, that finishes that Dennis' quest, which means we can now do some exploring and not worry about him.
You shouldn't be here, Ty. This is where Neddy lives. Neddy. Yes, Neddy. He's the biggest, toughest bully this side of the Black Stump.
Well, he doesn't sound so tough.
Nice one, Ty. Now you've riled him.
All right, we got ourselves a mini boss against Neddy. Just gotta smack his ass when he's not looking. Come on, Neddy, let's go, let's go. Oh, it's fine. Doesn't really matter what rank you use, just gotta hit him. Let's go, slut, huh? Huh, what do you got, huh? Bitch! Yay, we killed a man, and now we are rulers of the Black Stump. Fuck you, Neddy, you bitch. Making good progress, about just around the 200 mark, which honestly ain't half bad. Yeah, these levels are just not that long, which is honestly fine by me. I'm a busy adult. I work 50 fucking hours a week. I will take these short spurts of video games if I can get them. Grab these. Here's what we got. We got another turkey mission, except this one's a bit more difficult because now we have two turkeys to grab at the same time. But just like the last episode, just gonna get close. I have the power!
See if you can dive into that yellow crate.
Yeah, here's another little mechanic dive. Doesn't do anything too special other than just a quick entry into the water. It's flashy, that's about it. it's nothing special. If you're up to the challenge, anyway, let's do this easy ass mission. Why do these characters just casually carry thunder eggs on them? Whew. Did I get it? Yep. Ah, see, look, I knew I missed one. I'm always gonna miss some. You think you were close enough to grab it with your magnet butt, but nope, you weren't close enough at all. Almost there. Okay, I'm missing a box or a collection that's underwater. Hope it's... Fuck. What the hell am I missing? It had to be a box at least, right? So we'll make our way back to the beginning. Probably missed a stupid box over here. Right there from the fuck. There we go. Alright. Now, this may not look like it, but this is probably the hardest gear to get in the game. So you have to make this really stupid jump. I think the idea is to come back here with another item that allows you to make platforms, wink, wink, nudge, nudge, foreshadowing, but, you know, here at the Jax221 channel, we don't like to play like that. We like to get everything 100% as we go. So let's see how many jumps it takes for me to get this one cog. I fucking hate it. Oh, come on! Ah, there we go, got it. Ooh. I think that's my newest record for that. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is Moonlight Over the River Tai. Yes! Alright. Let's get the hell out of here. Ooh, we're in. Welcome to the Great White North, bitches. Alright, gotta go save the kids. We gotta go save kids because Mama Bear... Wait, Mama Bear? No, koalas aren't bears. Who the fuck ever called a koala a bear as a dumbass? I hate that misconception. Anyway, we gotta go save them kids. Unlike the past couple levels, which has kind of been a... which has been like kind of a straightforward path. This one just really opens up right off the start. Just looking at this map, you can see a definitive beginning and a definitive end, but like, it's not one path. It's just, it's a sandbox, or in this case, a snowbox. Not only does it save koala babies, we also gotta save... What are these things called? Bilbies, that's it. Jesus. Totally forgot what those things were called. That was a bilby. But you gotta save five bilbies in order to get a thunder egg. But we got to save eight koala babies to get a thunder egg. So, if my calculations are correct, Jonathan, one bilby is the equivalent to at least one and one third koala babies. Post me, do the math, see that's correct. Probably the second hardest. The second hardest cog to get in the game. Is what you gotta do is you gotta line up your shot. Okay. Yeah, you could do this by sliding across, but somehow I fucked up the slide. But then if you just slowly tiptoe... Oh. Slowly tiptoe. Got it! That was weird.
Is that a Biff Casarita? Fuck yeah. That's what I'm talking about.
Yes! Fuck you, lobster! You stupid crustacean bitch! That teaches you for touching my shit! But probably one of the easiest to grab. No, probably not that easy. It's just sitting right here, that's it. It's like, you did it! We've ran out of ideas, but you did it. You made it to the top. Now congratulate yourself with fun. Okay, I gotta make sure to grab all these, because last time I played this level, I forgot one that was right there. Ah! See? I knew it! I knew one would have gotten fucked up in there. I was smart. I played the game at itself and won! Isn't this, like, just... Oh. Alright. I think that's how I get this one. Yes! That's what I like to see. Using my knowledge. That's knowledge, power, video games. We know how to break Tide to Tasman 1. So this one was the hard one. This has got like 50 bajillion saw blades. But look at that. As I jump over all 50 bajillion saw blades. Making our way towards the mill. Oh, yeah, look at that. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's good. Good, good, good. And bada bing, bada boom! That raises the three platforms, the gas-powered sticks that they are. Come on. Come on, just get me up there. Boom, baby! And then we're gonna fly over here. Deposit these. Yeah, baby! Then we're gonna run over here. Teleport back. Turn around. Talk to you.
6, 7, 8. All accounted for.
Boom, baby! Oh, baby, a triple! We're gonna teleport on out of here. We got one more level than the boss, baby! Let's go! And we're in, boys! We gotta... Who's this?
What? That's you! How you doing, buddy? How you doing?
Mum.
Aw, he's a big pussycat when you get to know him. Right, Ty?
Yeah, right as rain. I'll use this, me laser
gun! Yeah, welcome to probably the most unique stage in the video game. This is technically our weird, vehicle stage of the game. I mean, control's pretty average. I don't know what to say about this. We're riding a giant pig in a desert area. It's kind of a zen level, not gonna lie. Got a tornado. Oh shit, no. Not the one thing that can kill me. I don't want it. I don't want it dead. Dead, I don't like it. Because this is it. This is what this level mostly is. It's just kind of just this free-roaming vehicle stage. Just looking for stuff. Like, this level has probably, like, the least amount of engagement as all the other levels do. But you know what? It's a fun level. It's fun. It's unique. It's different. It mixes up the gameplay. Let's go up here to where Ranger Ken is. Hi, Ranger Ken. Oh, that looks like... Ooh, can I even jump off that? No, I cannot. Ranger Ken, what do you got for us today?
That Galar boss Cass decided this would make a nice little toxic waste dump. I don't know how, Ty, but we have to stop those pumps.
You got it, Ranger Ken. Let's do this.
You're a top bloke, Ty.
Got it! Woo! Perfect record! Let's go! Let's go! Goddamn eco-terrorism for the win!
On you, mate. You did it.
Get the fuck out of here, big oil! Alright, Ken, what do you got for us again?
It's a real scorcher today, and a few spot fires have broken out.
Oh no! Time to wreak havoc by saving the town. The only way to save the town from itself is to destroy it. We're helping! Once again, Ranger can't hold it out on us. The bastard.
Okay, Ty, you ready?
We'll see if you can find the box on our way there. Ah, shit, we're started. Yeah. I was too distracted to think about that last box. But it don't matter. I will win this race, Shiva. Fuck, tornadoes. Why did tornadoes got the suck? We're gonna win this. We're gonna go to Chuck E. Cheese, Mom. I already got a full 10 body lead on her. This bull power is better than her horsepower. Keep an eye on those boxes. Ah, shit, she's pulling ahead. I don't know how she is, but she is. But we're not gonna let her. Ride, bully, ride. This is where it slows down a bit. No. Fight it. Win it. Complete it. Look at that, look at that. Oh, shortcut. Oh, I can cut those corners. Oh, fuck. Yes, queen. Yes.
Whoa, you beat me fair and square.
Damn right I did.
You deserve this.
Thanks, bitch.
I have a lock on the talisman. This should be extremely simple. Yes, indeed. Simple as can be. Yes, no.
Got it. Uh-oh. There it is. The platypus diamond. Got it. Welcome to boss fight number 2. Crikey's Cove. And unlike Bully, the Bully boss room, this one's kind of got some, got way more excess to it. Like, I'll show you what I mean. Like, beyond this net is the boss room. For some reason, the second boss in the game has all this explorable area that does nothing. See, look. Can't even reach us from right here. What a loser. We'll swim past him though, because there is actually one thing you can do. If you swim underwater, there's this tunnel. The tunnel takes you to the lighthouse area. You get a nice optical view of the entire base. How cool is that? Up here would be a one-up if you're playing on casual mode or standard mode. But, you know, one-ups don't exist in hardcore mode, so all we got is a pie. So I say, without further ado, let's take on boss number 2. Right, we beat a boss. We got some powers. So what new boomerangs will this reward us? Yes! Woo! Talk about the cold shoulder. With the ice ring, we can free shit. But we are not done with the ring upgrades just yet, because guess what we've been collecting? That's right, it's been golden cog time. So what new additional boomerangs shall be rewarded to us? Alright, our first of the new golden cog rings is the Infra Ring, which, if you can hear it right now, it's making a very loud beeping noise. That tells you something's close, and if you go to first person view, your world is all green. But if you look up, what's that box doing there? Well, it's not there anymore, but now it is. So yeah, Infra Rings, our primary use is to find these invisible boxes that hold a collectible artwork in it. So yeah, I've been holding off on these because they don't really play into your 100% totals, but you can collect art. That's what it is. Just collecting artwork. That's it. Nothing special. The artwork's cool. It's fun to look at, but not worth checking out if you're trying to just get 100%. But that's the primary function of the Infra Rings, just to find artwork boxes. And for our second new boomerang, it's the Mega Ring. I love these. So they're basically your standard boomerangs, except they auto-target enemies. So I could be like standing right here, and let's say that wallaby is an enemy. Just throw the Mega Ring and it would kill it on sight. I love these things. They are really cool. Shuriken look to them. So they got a nice look. Definitely my favorites boomerang to use in the game. Definitely put them at S tier if there was a Thai Tasmanian Tiger official boomerang tier list. Anyway, I do believe that it is that time of the episode to call it a day, for we got 100% at Crikey's Cave. And as Mori so graciously said to us, let's walk over there. Stalling for time. In the next episode of Thai Tasmanian Tiger, we are going to progress to Cass Pass. I think that's what it's called. I don't know. We're going on to the next area. So I will catch you all next time.